Did you listen to Jeff and Professor Hamo in the morning? Here's what you
did. There's so many problems. I mean, kids today, you pick up a paper every single day. Suicide rates are on the rise. People are so stressed. They kill their families. They kill themselves. It's horrible out there. I mean, what is it? Is it lifestyle or what is it?
I'll say the definition of stress, which is given by the founder of our organization, Gurudev Shri Ravi Shankar. He says the definition of stress is when there's so much to do, very less time and almost no energy. Now the demand, you cannot decrease it. The way we are growing, there's going to be a lot of competition, a lot of demand. Time, you cannot do anything about it unless you really move to some other planet, which is not a possibility.
Good yet.
But definitely you can do something with your energy levels. A bit of exercise, right proper food and breathing techniques, and some mind relaxing techniques. If you just do it for a couple of days, you will see people are coming out of depression. They are giving up their weapons also. Like a lot of terrorist organizations we have worked with, and we have been instrumental in peace resolution, conflict resolution. It is easy because a wrong thought in the mind can be corrected with the right thought in the mind also. So we work on the mind. It is possible.
It is possible, you say, Nimo, but it's easier said than done.
Depression now.
Depression is real.
And people are under pressure every day. You know,
Nimo.
Yes.
This society we live in, I call it the microwave society. We need generation.
No.
You want instant gratification, which is, you know, it's impossible.
And this is what I came to talk about, that, you know, we live in a society where everything has to be given to us right away. Whether it's a phone call, whether it's an interview you're waiting for, whether it's a relationship waiting to happen, or being happy. And one thing I want to say is we've learned as a society to postpone our happiness until something happens. And through the breath, if you notice, your breathing is with you every moment. And moment to moment, you learn through the breath how to be happy in the present moment. So you're happy doing your job. You're content being in a relationship, and through that you're able to improve your life rather than wait for something to happen. So I wait until, yes, I have $10 million in my account, then I'll be happy. But if you look right now in your life, there are people waiting for you to be happy and acknowledge that, yes, I'm there. So the improvement and the happiness is right here, this moment. And it's through breathing. It's also scientifically proven as well.
So, what kind of breathing are we talking about? Is it, you know, 60 breaths per minute or 70?
Or a deep one in the belly?
What is it?
You know, before we even go to the breathing techniques, we have to understand why breathing. If you see when you're angry, immediately your breath changes and becomes faster.
Yes.
You do not choose to breathe this way. You don't say, hey, I'm angry, give me a moment, I want to breathe faster.
No, that's not
the moment you feel angry, your breath goes faster.
Yeah.
In fact, if you're breathing faster, people get to know, hey, I push away from the person, this guy is going to attack me.
Yeah?
Yeah.
So it takes less than seconds for your breath to change when you feel emotion of anger. And when you're happy, the breath goes longer and deeper. You say, oh, something is very beautiful. This is how you say it. So I'm saying the reverse phenomenon. If you work on your breath, it will immediately impact your mind. So you don't have to wait for days. It can happen in just few minutes of some rhythmic breathing exercises. So the breathing technique which we teach in Art of Living is called Sudarshan Kriya, S-K-Y. So this is something really very powerful, very simple to do, and it will not take you weeks. It will just take you one session of 1 hour to experience, hey, something has changed inside me. Because you cannot change outside. If I tell you to change people, it will not happen. You have to change yourself. You have to see something has to move from inside, because you can be in the worst situation, but if your mind is okay, you will enjoy it. But if your mind is not okay, you can be the best of the place, the dream destination. One wrong message can spoil your holiday completely. So it is power of the mind we need to understand.
Some people talk about meditation. Is this close to meditation here?
I'll say this leads you to a state where your mind is peaceful and relaxed. Now you call it meditation, you call it mindfulness, whatever you call. It's a very peaceful state of mind, not an empty state of mind.
Yeah.
Peaceful, relaxed state of mind, in which helps you to take decisions. You know, if you're angry, your mind is all the time waving. You won't be able to understand the other person's point of view.
Yes.
So this breathing technique leaves you to a state where you feel complete stillness, relaxation of your mind.
Yeah.
Any vocabulary you can use about it.
Okay, Nimo, let me give you an example.
Mm-hmm.
People on the Thika Superhighway right now, mm-hmm. getting to work.
They're in traffic.
Traffic is a mess.
Mm-hmm.
There's some guy who's just overlapped you,
mm-hmm.
come in front of you,
mm-hmm.
didn't even say thank you.
No.
No courtesy.
In fact, hooting. And then there's a message from your boss. Where are you?
So you're stressed,
yes.
and you're angry.
Mm-hmm.
And in fact, in some countries, they mm-hmm. call it road rage.
Yes.
Mm. We haven't gotten to that yet, and I'm surprised, but I've seen road rage in countries like South Africa and mm-hmm. the US. Mm-hmm. What do you do in such an instant, Nimo? You're there, you're stressed, you've left home, you've had an argument with your wife,
yes.
your kid hates you,
mm-hmm.
Your boss is almost...
He's waiting for you.
And this guy just cut you in traffic.
Yes.
Talks to me. How do I breathe?
So the first thing you need to do is observe and become aware of your breath. Have you noticed? We only notice our breath when we're either running or we're angry or we're asked to breathe deeply. Like right now, I'm asking everybody who's feeling that way, and I know many people are,
mm-hmm.
just take a deep breath in and breathe out. It's very simple. And then after that, you'll notice how you start to automatically just relax. There'll be some clarity in the mind, some feeling of release. You know, 80% of our toxins are released through the breath.
Mm-hmm.
And right now, everybody's only using 20% of their lung capacity.
20%?
Only 20. And we need to know how to increase the lung capacity. How
okay.
to keep on taking a deep breath. Because if you notice, when your children, your grandchildren, your nieces, your nephews, when they take a breath in, their stomachs are going right up, if you notice.
Yeah.
Now, if you look at your stomach, okay, if, you know, you are.
Some of us yeah. already, you know,
six pack.
Ours are already out there. So
yeah,
you don't see
the one
pack. It's a huge one, but
uh-huh.
I mean.
So just breathe in.
Yes. And breathe out.
Yeah, and you know one thing, like we have a lot of, we have five golden rules in Art of Living, because
mm.
you breathe, you exercise, you practice breathing, but it's something you have to carry your wisdom also.
Okay.
So there's a golden rule which says, the present moment is inevitable.
Mm-hmm.
So when you realize this, that the kind of situation you describe,
mm-hmm.
traffic jam, everybody honking, overtaking, whatever, then you see, can I actually do something about this moment? No, I cannot do. This is the way it is. So the moment you think about it, you immediately feel a stillness. Okay, let me just raise the volume. Let me enjoy, because anyways I cannot do anything about it.
Yes.
I'm not talking about a passive. I'm saying being active about it. This
mm-hmm.
is a jam. I cannot move my car.
Mm-hmm.
Even if I honk something. So let me not waste peace of my mind. So this is the technique which, or tool I say, you can use in these kind of situations. But it can only be used when your mind is already relaxed.
Yeah.
So that is what happens to the breathing techniques, and this is the Art of Living is all about, I say.
I want to get in touch with you right away,
oh,
and I'm
yes.
sure there's a lot of people out there who want to get in touch. How do they do it? How do they get in touch with the Art of Living?
They can log on to our website, www.artofliving.org. Our numbers are there. They can call us anytime. And we'll also be doing a session, an open session, which is free and open to everybody to attend. Anybody who's stressed.
When is it?
And that's on Monday from 6 to 7 in General Mothenge. It's called in Westlands. It's,
mm-hmm.
it's a hotel called Casa Kingfisher. So we invite everybody to come and join us to experience, have a taster of the breathing that can help to change your life and change 450 million people's lives around the world. We have a global reach.
6 to 7 p.m.
Well, what time? What time?
P.m.
6 to 7 p.m.
After work.
Yeah, right after work when you're really stressed.
Yes, bring your stress home. Bring it, we'll breathe you out.
Nitin, now it's not just in the inner cities that you go, you even visit prisons.
Yeah.
Prisons.
Yes.
Go on.
Because the prisons, they are the inmates are the people who actually need it also. Yeah, because our founder says there's always a victim in a culprit who is crying for help. If we will not go to those prisons, then who will go over there? So Nimo has taught, some of our other teachers have also taught in Kenya. I myself taught last in four prisons. Committee Maximum Prison, Langata Women's Prison, Kisumu Kotiaga Prison, mm-hmm. and the Lamu prison called Hindi. So we are the first organization ever to go to Hindi prison in Lamu and teach them the art of living. And I'm happy to share, some of them are now out, the inmates are now out, and they have become our volunteers. They say, we want to do what are you doing for the society. So it's working over there, yeah.
People are breathing in prison.
In prison.
Absolutely relaxing.
Not only prison, in Lamu. There's a prison in Lamu.
Hindi prison. And people, I tell you, let me tell you, the people there are more sincere
than the ones outside.
You know why? Because they are for a reason. They know we cannot go out, so that brings a lot of their attention, awareness to the what is being taught over there. They have got beautiful experiences. I remember one guy told me, he said, you are working on us, but what about those people who are doing things outside? Why, if you meet, I hope you would have met us before, met us before, we would not have been in the prison. Can you see? I mean, that really touched heart.
www.artofliving.org, folks, listen up. Anyone who feels stressed, this changed your life. Nimo says they've reached 450 million people
in past 39 years.
Globally.
And we are a volunteer-based organization, so all of us are volunteers, so we don't get paid for anything. So the program which we do in prisons and in slums also, like last year, I did a program called the YLTP. It's called Youth Leadership Training Program in Kibera. So the youth from Kibera, Mathare, Kavangware, and some of the colleges and schools, they came, 91 youths were trained for 6 days. For lodging and their food, everything we take care of. In 6 days we train them, and they share amazing experiences that they have, how their life has got changed, how they have got direction about their life. Now they feel more empowered. Their relation with their parents have improved. You know, one of the guy told me, his mother said, I don't know what are you doing, where did you go, but you are a changed person. I've developed a new relation with you. You're a new son to me. I'm a new mother to you. A lot of changes are happening.
So Nimo, this does work. I mean, it's obvious, it does work.
It changed my life. I want to speak to all the youth out there. I want to tell them that I went through a major, I was bullied in school. I had difficulty studying. I came last, almost my tutors didn't even know what to call my grades. And the breathing technique, it helped me to understand what I wanted to achieve in my life. And I've used that every single day, including the amazing little knowledge nuggets that he had shared on how to live your life. We need to know how to deal with our anger. We need as a society to know how to deal with our depression. How can we deal with a child that's not able to understand despite every effort of the parent, despite every effort of the family members to deal with their life, to deal with their challenges? We need to educate our own mind, educate our own lives, so that we can use these skills, these tools, which can reach out and make us a successful human being, not just a human. And I want to tell everybody out there, there are good people everywhere. We've forgotten as a society to acknowledge that, to see how those good people are in our lives, in our situations. And for those who are not yet there, I would say, you know, reach out. We as a society have also forgotten how to listen. And the beauty about the Art of Living programs is it brings out that humanness in you again. You relearn how to listen. You relearn how to be yourself, finally. The way 470 million people around the world have learnt as well. I think everybody needs to stand up and for themselves, for society, and say, hey, I want to do something for my society. I want to do something for my country. I know I'm doing it and I'm going to contribute back. And that's all I've been doing, sharing my experience to people, telling them, come on, just do this breathing technique. It changed my life. I've used it for 15 years. I've been married for 15 years. How do you deal with a difficult relationship? Nobody today can say, I'm not in a difficult relationship. Whether it's with your boss, whether it's with your colleague, your sibling, your neighbor,
or your spouse,
or the person next to you in the car. We've got to have those skills. It's like an inbuilt tool that you can use anytime. It's free, it's your breath, You don't need to take or pay anything for it.
Nitin, when we were growing up, we never had this thing here.
Mm-hmm.
I'm talking about the mobile phone.
Mm-hmm.
We never had it here with us.
Yeah.
Today, even little kids are walking around with mobile phones, and the content in there is just shocking, mind-blowing stuff. And then you see people practicing what they see in some of these videos. I mean, we're not talking violence here.
Mm-hmm.
Can we avoid that? Can we do less of that through these techniques?
Yeah, I'll say, you know, we cannot stop the technology or the growth that we have in the world. In fact, in a way, it is good.
Mm-hmm.
Because now we have the kids who know everything about the mobile, which website to go, how to download everything, which is in a way good. Because this is how they will survive in the world coming. But at the same time, again, I say, we've got 24 hours in a day. I'm saying, if you just spend 20 minutes with yourself, to improve the quality of those 23 hours and 40 minutes, which is possible. You know, we never stop eating, because if you don't eat, you will die.
Yeah.
So we always give priority to that thing. But now I'm saying, just 20 minutes a day. If you just attend to your breath, just spend some time with yourself, these violence tendencies can be brought down. This a lot of hyperactivity in the mind can be done, because if you see, nobody has taught us, never in the school, at home, nobody has taught us how to deal with these emotions which we label as negative emotions, like jealousy, hatred, and so violence, so many. Everybody says, yes, this is wrong, you should not have them. But how not to have them? It is very natural to have these kind of emotions, basis your personality and whatever situations you are into.
Mm-hmm.
I'm saying there's nothing wrong with that, but nobody has taught us how to deal with them, how to control them. So I'm saying just 20 minutes of breathing can really make a difference to your life.
Mm-hmm.
And it works. That is why millions of people across the globe are coming to these breathing techniques and art of living, and that is the only key.
Yeah.
Very much to that.
Yeah.
Nimo, how important is sleep at night?
Mm.
How important, and how many hours is adequate?
I think it's the most important.
Oh. Because you're talking to a nocturnal being.
Yes.
Oh.
But I'll tell you, the maximum requirement is 8 hours of sleep. The minimum is 6. And if you don't reach there, then you definitely have to work on your breathing. You know, if you Google, and I'm using Google as an example, and you just type breathing, you search, 1.5 million hits will come on different research articles, different benefits of breathing, different news articles.
Mm-hmm.
Will tell you all about how, through breathing, your sleep can be improved.
Yeah.
And one more thing, when we don't have good sleep, our mental health is affected. When I talk about mental health, I talk about your ability to create the best life for yourself. And why you're not able to do that? Because when you don't have clear thinking, let's say you get up in the morning and feel, oh my God, I feel so drowsy, I feel foggy inside. What do? I can't deal with this anymore. So the first thing you do is a cup of coffee and shout at the person next to you. Yes, I say the first thing you should do, breathe. 20 minutes of the breathing technique, 20 minutes. And now I'm not just saying just do deep breathing and it's okay. No, it's a very systematic, scientifically researched and a beautiful technique that we teach. That can just change your sleeping rhythms and patterns.
Okay, again, Monday, we're coming to this hotel in Tenomathenga. Tell us again the details.
So it's Casa Kingfisher from 7 to 8. It's on General Mathenge, just off Piponi Road. You can Google the details. You can Google the directions. I would say everybody's welcome. Come and get a taster. Even just that taster session, we would be teaching you something that you could take home to do every day on your own. Just a small technique, and you'll notice improvements in how more oxygen goes to the brain. Everybody knows when more oxygen goes to the brain, the sleep is better, the focus is better, the productivity is better. So even for corporate people who have the most hectic lifestyle, and I'd let Nitin talk about that because he's had 10 years...
In the corporate. You were in the corporate.
I was. I worked in more than 10 years in corporate.
Yeah.
And, you know, I remember when I used to leave my office, I used to have this back pain, and which I've almost understood as part of my life now. Yeah, I will never get rid of this back pain. and going into your cab back to your home, and you're feeling like almost started feeling old age. Yeah, so I was like, it's okay, everybody, all my colleagues were saying, it's okay, now you have reached your, you know, close to your late 20s or 30s, it's okay, now you're working, work for 10 years, everything. I was like, no, there has to be some way. So the moment I did my active living program, and now today I also teach some of the yoga techniques, postures to people. I also am a yoga teacher also. And the back pain has gone forever. So yes, it works. It definitely works. And there's never a wrong time to start the right thing in your life.
www.theartofliving.org. Mm-hmm. Folks, it could change your life.
Jeff,
this could change your life.
You're saying the phone, eh?
Yes.
You know you live for likes now. You can correct. Find someone in an accident.
Yes.
Instead of helping them, you're taking a video.
Yes.
You know, you're going live. Yeah. Instead of helping.
You're
and these are the people we are talking to.
Yeah.
Telling them, please breathe. Is it the pressure of life that has reached us to that point where
everyone's
we don't
looking
care.
For likes, everyone's looking for friends or numbers on Twitter and Facebook and Instagram.
Yes.
You want to be loved, but they don't really love you out there. They they don't care about you.
And you don't want this physical love. You just want it here, visually, so that you don't control me, but you love me out here.
Unfortunately, you know, the interference of technology so much, especially the social media, has resulted in a situation when, very rightly said, when you don't want to help the person, but you want to make a video so that you get the likes.
Yes.
I'll say this is, in a way, a degradation of the human values also. So it's very important for us to create an atmosphere where the people are stress-free, because if you're stress-free, then these kind of values which already you have inside you, they will come forward more in you. So we have to, and we have to build a society which is a violence-free and a stress-free society.
Mm-hmm.
And this is the mission of our founder. He says, I want a society which is violence-free and stress-free also. It can be done. I'm sure it will take some time. The kind of mess up we have done.
Yeah.
And you know, like, and it is going more and more, but at the same time, that is why we need these kind of people with that intention and mission that, no, I want to reach out to as many people as possible, so that we don't degrade further.
Nemo, do you get stressed?
I get stressed, yes, but I know how to deal with my stress now.
Mm-hmm.
That's it.
Yeah.
And you do your breathing technique in the morning or in the evening, and you feel like you can just take on any challenge. I faced many challenges myself. One was, of course, I talked a little bit about it when I was going through my exams, and I found it very difficult to focus. And one of the things I also found was, hey, I'm now growing up to be an adult, and I have to compete with the rest of the world.
Yeah.
That can be very overwhelming for somebody who's just about 16 years old,
yeah,
moving on to university, not understanding. You know, nowadays we have such insular families, I would say. Before we had, when our grandmothers were there and our uncles were there, it was a more holistic approach to life. And nowadays our holistic approach is Google, do this, do that. I have to go for a meeting, I have to do this, you know. And so for me, I feel that when you're stressed and you have the breathing technique, it's an option out of your stress. It's not an alternative, it's a way of life. That's it.
Wow.
Yeah.
And Nitin, what do you do when you're stressed?
When I'm stressed, normally now I don't get stressed so much, because I have developed a way of not letting myself lose to the moments of getting stressed. But yes, if you get stressed, you have to accept it, that yes, I'm getting stressed. The moment if you see, you accept this, that I'm getting stressed or angry, the moment you will see that it is leaving you immediately. So this is also one of the games which you can play with your mind, and which can immediately give you results. So if you're angry, if you're not aware, it's like you're sleeping. The moment you say, no, I'm getting angry, that very moment you will say, it will settle down gradually.
Yeah.
So these are techniques and many tools which we teach in our different programs, which helps.
www.theartofliving.org. Get on it. And this coming Monday, 7 to 8 p.m. off General Mathenga Drive.
Yeah.
What's the hotel? Something?
Kingfisher Casa.
Kingfisher Casa.
Hey. Yeah?
Twindibana.
No, macho. Are you looking at our eyes? We need a lot of breathing, bro.
And sleep. And sleep.
I love it.
All right, if there's someone who's listening to you for the very first time, either they're in traffic or they've just reached work on their headphones or they're at home and they've just heard this conversation, what do you tell them, Nimo? What do you tell them right now? And they are stressed to the limits.
I want to ask them, what is the first sign of success? Is it the fact that you have a big car or a big house?
Of course.
Or is it the children that you have?
Uh-huh.
Or is it the smile that you're keeping on your face today? I want to know which one it is.
I think that big car brings that to hand. There's a coordination.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Nitin, what do you tell them?
I'll say a very simple thing, you know. The way we brush our teeth every day, we never forget to do that. It is called dental hygiene. This is the way you also have to work on your mind, which is called mental hygiene. So I'm saying just take care of your dental hygiene and also mental hygiene, and there is a way out. You have to believe us. In today's society, when we need everything instantly, we have some instant tools for you. And don't worry, the first step has to be taken by you. If you don't take first step, then we cannot also not do anything about it.
Yeah.
But yes, we are here. There are techniques for you to help out. And you don't have to worry and get angry about anything.
It's called the art of living, folks. This could change your life.
Mm.
And I think, I hope, I believe we have changed a couple of lives today. Nitin Diwar, Nimo Shah, thank you so much, guys. This has been very stimulating.
So one of the techniques which we can share right now is a very simple one. You just have to simply put your palm on your stomach.
Mm-hmm.
Because other tools I have to demonstrate like a visual. Yeah?
Right.
So this is a very, you just put your palm on your stomach and just breathe in. Breathe out. Now you have to see if your stomach is expanding or contracting. In case if your stomach is contracting, consciously you have to expand your stomach. Now once again, let's do it. Take a breath in. And breathe out. Once again, long and deep breath in. Keep a smile in your face and breathe out. Last time, long and deep breath in. Breathe out. And relax. You can slowly open your eyes in case if you close your eyes. So what you have to see is, in case if your stomach is contracting while you're inhaling, so now you have to consciously expand it, because due to toxins, negative emotions, stress over the many years, our breathing pattern also changes. So a lot of people, we experience in courses, they say when they breathe in, the stomach contracts. It shouldn't be, because diaphragm is like a balloon, it should expand. So this technique, when you lie down or even you're sitting, just say 10 to 15 breaths, conscious breaths, long and deep breaths, and expand your stomach when you breathe in, and when you breathe out, you contract your stomach. You will see in just a couple of days, you'll feel something is happening to my body and my mind.
Catch Jeff Koinange and Professor Hamo every day, Monday to Friday from 6 a.m. to 10 a.m. only on Hot 96.